In this video, I'm going to explain basic anatomy around scapula. Understanding anatomy is very, very important. Let's get started from posterior part. By the way, you are looking scapula from posterior, and this is right side scapula. Let's start with these two parts. This is medial border because this is medial part. Imagine there are thoracic spines. Medial border. This is lateral border. Medial border, lateral border. What is this part? This is inferior angle. Inferior angle. If there is inferior angle, there should be superior, right? Where is it? Where is superior angle? It's right here. This is superior angle. Medial border, lateral border, inferior angle, and superior angle. Let's go to anterior view little quick. You know, I just explained medial border and lateral border. There is superior border right here. Superior, medial, lateral. Make sense? Superior border. Now let's go back to posterior view. What is this part? This is spine of scapula. Spine of scapula. By the way, on the most lateral part of spine of scapula is acromion. It has different name, right? This is spine of scapula, now becomes acromion. Very flat, wide part, okay? Spine of scapula, acromion. Now, below spine of scapula, this surface is kind of concave surface, right? This is infraspinous fossa. Infraspinous fossa. Because this is lower than spine of scapula. This is how I remember. Infraspinous fossa. Infraspinous fossa. Make sense? There is infraspinous fossa. There should be supraspinous fossa. Correct? Where is supraspinous fossa? It's right here. This part. This is superior view. You know? This concave surface, okay? Supraspinous fossa, because it is relatively superior compared to spine of scapula. It's not completely superior, but, you know, it's relatively superior from this area, right? Infraspinous fossa and supraspinous fossa right here. Okay, medial border, lateral border, and inferior angle, superior angle, spine of scapula, infraspinous fossa, supraspinous fossa, right here. Now let's go to lateral part. You know, there is joint right here. This is glenohumeral joint, also known as shoulder joint, glenohumeral joint. The scapula part is kind of concave surface, okay? Now, this concave surface of scapula is glenoid fossa, glenoid fossa. This is concave surface. Now, humerus fits into the scapula, glenoid fossa. Head of humerus, glenoid fossa, fits like that. Make sense? Glenoid fossa. And on inferior part of glenoid fossa, there is tiny bump. This is infraglenoid tubercle. Infraglenoid tubercle. On superior part, there is supraglenoid tubercle. Supraglenoid tubercle and inferior glenoid tubercle. These landmarks are very important to understand attachment of muscles, okay? Okay, this is pretty much posterior part of scapula. Let's go to anterior part. Okay, I just explained superior border in first part, right? Superior border. By the way, this is superior angle. Medial border, lateral border, inferior angle. And anterior surface of scapula is also concave. What is this place? This part is subscapular fossa. Subscapular fossa. On this part, subscapularis attaches. So this is kind of easy to remember. Subscapular fossa, subscapularis. Okay? And what is this hole? This is suprascapular notch. Suprascapular notch. This is very, very tiny place. You see this size of this one? And it's very tiny, tiny space. Okay? Subscapular fossa. Suprascapular notch. And what is this? This is coracoid process. Coracoid process. It's part of scapula and it has very, very unique shape. You see that? This place is also important because there are three muscles attached this place. Okay? Coracoid process. Subscapular fossa, suprascapular notch, and coracoid process. Okay, this is pretty much it. Very important anatomical places in scapula. Let's review from posterior view. This is medial border, lateral border, inferior angle, superior angle, spine of scapula, acromion, infraspinous fossa, supraspinous fossa, okay? Glenoid fossa, infraglenoid tubercle, supraglenoid tubercle. Let's go to anterior view, superior border, subscapular fossa, suprascapular notch, and coracoid process. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of scapula. There are many, many muscles attached on scapula. Remembering name of landmark will help you understanding muscles. I hope this video helps your understanding of anatomy. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.